The national government expresses concern on the assault of a Hong Kong pro-democracy protester at the Chinese consulate in Manchester, England. The victim is said to have sustained injuries after a group of men dragged him into the consulate during a peaceful demonstration over the weekend. Downing Street called the incident deeply concerning. An investigation is now underway. China's foreign ministry has denied knowledge of the event. It also insisted its embassies and consulates in Britain have always followed the law. A stronger maritime presence eyed by the U.S. in the South China Sea to secure the Indo-Pacific. U.S. Homeland Security Secretary Alejandro Mayorkas says Washington is investing $60 million worth of maritime initiatives in the region. Mayorkas told reporters the U.S. Coast Guard is also ready to deploy assets at the request of countries for maritime training as well as for security cooperation.
Assets and additional personnel through the region to help meet partners' request for maritime training, capacity building, and other ways in which we can most closely support and work with our partners in the region, whether it is to counter illegal, unreported, and unregulated fishing, or whether it is to deploy a cutter to Southeast Asia and for security cooperation and to operate as a training platform.
British Prime Minister Liz Truss apologizes for her mistakes that roiled financial markets and caused investor confidence to evaporate. But the embattled premier told the BBC she would not step down.
What I'm focused on is delivering for the British public. Now, I recognize we have made mistakes. I'm sorry for those mistakes, but I've fixed the mistakes. I've appointed a new chancellor. We have restored economic stability and fiscal discipline. And what I now want to do is go on and deliver for the public.
Truss endured a tough day in politics after the last of her tax-cutting plans was thrown out by her newly appointed finance minister, Jeremy Hunt, raising questions about who was actually in charge.
Mr. Speaker, what is she left with? No authority, no credibility, no plan for growth. And it is clear to see the people who caused the chaos cannot be the people to fix the chaos. Yeah. They are out of ideas, out of touch, and out of time.
A retired teacher in Hong Kong receives a suspended jail sentence for assaulting her Filipino domestic helper. The South China Morning Post reports the 65-year-old teacher pleaded guilty earlier this month to a count of common assault after admitting she had pulled the worker's hair and slapped her during an argument. She was jailed for 4 weeks, but the magistrate suspended the term for 1.5 years after finding no evidence that the defendant had previous records of physical abuse. At least 8 people are killed as Russia steps up its attack on Ukraine. So-called kamikaze drones and missiles set off multiple explosions on the capital, Kyiv, and on the northeast region of Sumy Monday. Ukraine says a married couple expecting a baby were among those killed in the attacks. Iran has been accused of providing Russia with the drones, which it swiftly denied. The U.S. now warning it would take action against companies and nations working with Iran's drone program.
Anyone doing business with Iran that could have any link to UAVs or ballistic missile developments or the flow of arms from Iran to Russia should be very careful and do their due diligence. The U.S. will not hesitate to use sanctions or take actions against perpetrators.